This is Thriller Forever, a video series chronicling every detail in the construction, release, and lasting impact of Michael Jackson's musical juggernaut. After finishing the other tracks for the album, Quincy Jones still felt something was missing. Quincy saying that he felt the album needed, quote, a song like My Sharona, a black version of a strong rock and roll thing. Beat It pulls Michael Jackson into an urban world and relays the pressure of a young man needing to prove himself in a tough street environment. Unsurprisingly, the 1961 musical adaptation was a huge inspiration for Jackson when composing Beat It. Its title lifted from the movie's opening line,
"Beat It."
With Thriller's edgier tracks Wanna Be Startin' Somethin', Billie Jean, and Beat It flooding radio airwaves and populating music charts around the world, Michael Jackson's music revolution was in full effect. However, the singer wasn't content purely releasing catchy pop hits, but aspired to show range and prove his other talents. As Jones would put it, quote, "To penetrate, you have to go for the throat in 4, 5, 6 different areas." And after a few high-heat songs in a row, it was time to cool things down. Toto keyboardist Steve Porcaro, along with some of his other bandmates, were assisting with the production of Thriller when Quincy asked if he had anything that could be pitched for the album. Running low on cassettes, Porcaro used a tape on which he had already recorded a demo called Human Nature, putting songs intended for Quincy Jones on the reverse side and marking on the label as to the side that should be listened to. Jones's gut instinct was that Porcaro's intended tracks were not quite right for Jackson. However, he didn't stop the tape, and the cassette deck automatically started playing the other side. As Jones described it, quote, "All of a sudden, at the end, there was all this silence. There was why, da-da-da-dum, da-da-da, why. Just a dummy lyric and a very skeletal thing. I get goosebumps talking about it. I said, this is where we want to go, because it's got such a wonderful flavor." Lyrically, Steve Porcaro's inspiration for Human Nature came to him after a conversation with his daughter after a boy hit her at school. Porcaro comforting her by saying, quote, "He probably likes you, and it's human nature."
We had one more mix to do, which was the song Africa. And I stopped by to see Heather on my way to the studio, and she'd had a rough day at school. And yeah, the title entered in my head, Human Nature, trying to explain why this boy who probably liked her and hit her at school that day. And the guys were in the booth putting up the mix, and I went out into the studio where the piano was, and pretty much the main chord structure of the song kind of all came to me at once.
He later created a demo for the track and presented it to Toto's other bandmates. However, they passed, stating it wasn't rock enough and felt the song would work better for someone else. Jones was excited about its potential, but was dissatisfied with the original lyrics. So he asked John Batiste, who had written hits for the likes of the Carpenters and the Pointer Sisters, to write some new ones. Porcaro reflecting on Batiste's contribution, quote, "He just nailed it. He turned my record into a song with a beginning, middle, and end." As the song developed, Jackson's breathy, lighter-than-air performance resulted in one of Thriller's most memorable moments, an ethereal, melodic symphony that cushioned Jackson's vocals as they float and swirl before taking flight with those oh-so-perfect and unscripted extended exclamations of why. By the late 1970s, Jackson's abilities as a vocalist were well-regarded. Rolling Stone critic Stephen Holden writing that, quote, "Jackson's feathery timbered tenor is extraordinarily beautiful. It slides smoothly into a startling falsetto that's used very daringly. Jackson's vocal delivery keeps the track feeling fresh, and the intoxicating melody feels as though it has been plucked from the future or another world entirely." Even though Jackson didn't write Human Nature, the unencumbered emotion in his voice gives no doubt that Jackson found resonance in its lyrics. An outsider from his window looking onto a thrilling city, the singer fantasizes about stepping out and connecting with the life that surrounds him, yet appears to be out of reach. Michael Jackson attempts to take himself off the pedestal of fame and pursue a woman he is interested in. The yearning for freedom and authentic personal connection being universal. Michael revealing desperate times of unhappiness and isolation in his autobiography. Quote, "I was so lonely. I wanted to meet people who didn't know who I was. I wanted to run into somebody who would be my friend because they liked me and needed a friend too, not because I was who I am.
I get afraid of, well, I don't know people. I get afraid of people sometimes. I don't, it's a whole nother life that I haven't really experienced that. Like friendship is a thing I'm just beginning to learn about. I was raised on the stage and that's where I'm comfortable. And everything else is like foreign to me. I'm just beginning to know and learn about people, friendship, and things like that.
Human Nature ultimately replacing another track, which had already been recorded, titled Carousel. A light, playful number that echoed similar sentiments found in Off the Wall's Girlfriend and Rock With You, as well as the Jackson Brothers' earlier bubblegum hits at Motown. A flirtatious whimsy that fans grew to expect as part of a Michael Jackson record, and that was delivered on Thriller with PYT, Pretty Young Thing. Written by James Ingram and Quincy Jones with a spring in its step, PYT is the album's designated infectious party jam. While not overly complex musically nor vocally challenging, there is a sweetness embedded into the track. A moment of fun dance pop that isn't meant to change the world, but will undoubtedly shuffle your feet as you listen. Quincy Jones came up with the original title after his wife, Peggy Lipton, brought lingerie with the words "Pretty Young Thing" printed on them. From there, Jones asked several songwriters to write a track around the title. Jackson penned a mid-tempo version of PYT with keyboardist Greg Fillinganes. However, Jones wanted an upbeat track, and when James Ingram presented his demo, Jones said, quote, "That's it," and sent Ingram home to finish the lyrics. Jones then suggested they extend the bridge and add a chant section, resulting in Jones receiving his only co-writer credit on the album. Michael Jackson professed his love for the version Ingram and Jones came up with, stating that he liked the code in the lyrics and the fact that the words like tenderoni were fun rock and roll type words that couldn't be found in the dictionary. James Ingram later described working with Jackson and Jones, quote, "It's almost like I got the chance to go to Oz, and Quincy was the Wizard of Oz, and Michael Jackson was who he was dealing with in his world. Their work ethic is unbelievable." For backing vocals, Swedeen positioned Jackson at different distances from the microphone to record each track, so to get a thicker sound. Two of Jackson's sisters, Janet and Latoya, also provided backing vocals, singing the na-na-na part behind their brother towards the end of the song in the guise of being the PYTs. When eventually released on September 19, 1983, PYT had already gained popularity with listeners and was in heavy rotation on black radio. A frizzy funk tune, it was a perfect remedy for Jackson fans on the lookout for a danceable groove in the post-disco era. Michael continued to serve this niche on the Thriller album by incorporating tracks written by Rod Temperton. Having previously written hits Always and Forever and Boogie Nights as a member of the multiracial R&B group Heatwave, Temperton was at this point a trusted Jones collaborator. Having previously contributed to Jackson's Off the Wall album, its title track Burned This Disco Out, and the mega hit Rock With You. Writing the upbeat but ultimately unreleased Got the Hots and Hot Street, Temperton ended up contributing three other songs that made it onto Thriller. This included the funk soul groove Baby Be Mine that finds Jackson in a more carefree space vocally than elsewhere on the album. Quincy Jones refers to Baby Be Mine as Coltrane done in a pop song. Quote, "Take a close look at Baby Be Mine," he said, starting to scat. It goes deedle-dee-doo, dee-dee-dee. That's Coltrane, man. It's got pop lyrics and a beat, but it's Coltrane. It all came from the same place. The frequent chord changes and occasional key shifts reflect bebop values, as do the quick splashes of background vocal fills. The production, and specifically Jackson's vocals, elevate the song from being purely filler, as one expects it would be on a lesser artist's album.